Crown Ford pace car. We'll catch the rundown when we can. We should be ready to go this time around. On the point, car number 7 is Keith Loveland. On the outside of Keith, the 28 junior is Wayne Pearson. Green flags out. We're racing. 6 cars to qualify. Keith Loveland, car number 7, jumps to the early lead, going into turn 1 and 2, followed by the 13 to front car of George Fisher. Up in the sun now goes the 21 of Robin Bly. Robin Bly, a man on the move, challenging on the inside, working the inside groove, takes over second, now takes over the lead. Robin Bly, swing shining, and a yellow flag comes out for the 28 junior. Again, the white monster, the pit road wall there, strikes out and takes the 28 junior. Severe damage there on the 28 junior car driven by Wayne Snooky Pearson, requiring obviously the hook of the Blair and Son wrecker from Charleston. The radiator broke going across the racetrack. The 28 junior out of Claremont, New Hampshire, is owned by Wayne Pearson and Cliff Dowdy, sponsored by B&B Building, Northland Builders, and Father and Son Drywall. 305 and 307 cubic inch Chevys, 302 cubic inch Fords, and 318 cubic inch Chrysler products. Okay, the number 21 car, Robin Bly. Out comes the green. George Fisher, Dawson Towns on the outside. Mind the whole inside group. Robin Bly on the inside now starts to pull away from the number 14 of George Fisher. Meanwhile, Tom Palantir, car number 11, now in the third, pounded by the number 00 Ray Crosby, who now switches to the outside and starts to challenge for the third position on the outside. Ray Crosby on the outside, Tom Palantir on the inside. Mac Johnson, number 9, Scotty Heeman, number 88, and a new car tonight, the 6X, is David Crow. Okay, eyes on turn 4. Out comes the green. We're racing. Out comes the green. Rock and roll for Douglas. Makes it 3 wide. Going in turn 1 and 2. Out goes the C97. Start tracking it up into turn number 2. breaking loose on turn number three is the 73 of Dennis Greenwood. Dennis Greenwood bringing up the yellow flag as he loops it in turn number three. Going for a wild ride up there into the sand, the Z97 car. Coming out of turns three and four, rapid rate for Douglas, keeping an eye on the zero car as they take the pack into turns three and four. Speeds pick up. Out comes the green as Corey Bly gets the early jump going down the home stretch into turn number one. In comes Corey Patton on the inside. The two Corey, now one or two. But look, here comes the four man, Mac Attack Johnson, car number nine. As car number nine and 50 get together, coming out of turn four, they straighten up and keep right on racing. Corey Patton on the outside. Scotty Heeman in the 88, Ken Fowler the number 8, Dennis Greenwood, car number 73, Steve Kim on the 5, and Steve followed by the 6X, the new race starts right off David Crow. Holy Fly, car number 0, now starting to feel the heat of Matt Johnson, the number 9. Ken Carles, back comes another 50.
Has his hooked up. Earl Taylor's still a rookie, getting better each week. Okay, Rick Crawford and Tommy Canfield now start to pick up speed coming out of three and four. Out comes the green. Tommy Canfield jumps to the early lead as they go by the starter stand. Tommy Canfield now being thrown by the 33 of Rick Crawford. Rick Crawford gets the inside word as Tommy Canfield drifts up high. Three wide going into turn number three. Your battle for third place. Rick Crawford shoots up high. Go to the left side as your lead cars get together. Tommy Canfield gets together with the 10. Jr. up to second, now taking over second. The number 13 is Craig Garren. Then comes Tommy Canfield, car number 08. Alan Fowles in the 29. Jerry Bradford, car number 17. Car of Steve Fry. Your race for the lead. Your race for the lead. second week up into the super stock class. Keep your eyes on the point cars. They come out of turns 3 and 4. Noel Bergeron picks up speed. Out comes the green. We're racing. Noel Bergeron on the inside. Ken Morris on the outside. The battle for the lead. Joining the battle, the number 99 is Dino Smith. Dino Smith now dives to the inside, up to third position. Noel Bergeron fighting to hold on the lead, now gets into the 27 car. The 27 and Noel Bergeron get together and into the line of position. A car number 96 into the turn one wall. The 96, Noel Bergeron. Your new lead car, the number 99 is Dino Smith. Up to second, car number 60 is Frank Buffum Jr. Running third, car number 13 is Keith Barron. Ken Morris now going back to position as Gary Gibbs, car number 25, now takes over fifth position. Your leader, Dino Smith. Then comes the 13 car, driven by Keith Tarrant. Keith Tarrant second, Frank Buffington in third and 60. Gary Gibbs going the high route in the traveling javelin. The traveling javelin, traveling high and wide, trying to take over third position for Frank Buff Jr. Out comes the black flag. Car number 8, Howard Keaton. Says his boat, perhaps blew it onto the racetrack. The black flag comes out for Howard Deets. Howard Deets goes up pit road off of turn number 3. Dino Smith now feeling the heat of the number 13, Keith Tarrant. Keith Tarrant dives to the inside. Dino Smith gets pushed up a little high. Keith Tarrant, car number 13, your new leader, up in the pit row, the number 27 of Ken Morris with sheet metal damage. Car number 13, your leader, Keith Tarrant, then comes Dino Smith, traveling, now travels up to third and dives to the outside. We're going uptown, uptown for the 25, the high groove, now challenging for second, the traveling javelin, two cars, the battle for second. On the outside, your battle for second as Frank Buffum Jr., car number 60, pushes up high. Two to go for your leader, Keith Tarrant. Dino Smith continues to fight to hold on to second on the inside. Car number 25, Gary Gibbs, now drives the inside himself, and look who's gonna shut the door on him. Dino Smith shuts the door on the 25 car. White flag, one to go. One to go for your leader, Keith Tarrant. Then comes Dino Smith. Gary Gibbs, number 60 car of Frank Buffum Jr. Gary Gibbs once again tries the inside. Look at that. Your lead car, your winner, the 13 is Keith Tarrant. Gary Gibbs takes second over Dino Smith. Light goes out, the car should be ready to run this time around. It's Fran the Man Perry and Mike Parks now take the field in the turn number 4. Green flag, we're racing. Mike Parks, car number 82, jumps into the early lead, going into turn number 1 and 2. Back to second goes Fran Perry in the 14. Now being challenged on the outside by Tom Strait. Tom Strait now up to second. Lenny Silver. Car number 94 running third. Then comes Frank Weigel, the 28. Ram riding on the outside. Jim Tarbell, car number 5. Jim Tarbell now takes over fourth in the live 5. Mike Parks, car number 82, your leader. Tom Strait, second. Lenny Silver, car number 94. Now challenging for second. Then comes Jim Tarbell, car number 5. Your battle for fifth. Andy Johnson on the outside. Car number 1 now takes over fifth. Drop kick back to 6 is Frank Weigel in car number 28. Mike Parks, your leader, going into 1 and 2. Tom Strait second. Randy Silver now starts to put the pressure on the 63, as does the number 5 of Jim Tarbell. Jim Tarbell going up high, taking over on the rim riding on the outside. Jim Tarbell behind him. Tosses down. Momentarily come together. Three wide, going into 3 and 4. The meat and the sandwich. Tom Strait in the 63. Jim Tarbell up high against the road. Car number 5. Jim Tarbell now takes over third on the outside. Jim Tarbell, homicide contact with a 63.
the black flag, obvious engine problems. Number 94 now slows down. Lenny Silva slows down. Looking all the way to the lead is a line five of Jim Carvel. Jim Carvel, your winner.
Donna Cross, please report to the ticket booth. Donna Cross to the ticket booth, please. Okay, eyes on three and four. Out comes the green. We're racing. Wayne Tossler picks up speed. Holding position going into one and two. Mark Blair on the outside. Trying to tuck in. However, the number three, Roger Shepard, has other ideas. Roger Shepard now takes over second as car number 30, Mark Blair, hung out to dry. Now goes back to third and now grabs the inside. Dick LaPlante, followed by Dave Lesgro in the 162. Car number 30, Mark Glass, flipped it coming out of turn number 4. Don't worry at all, car number 30, either a full 160 or 180, and then fires up and keeps on racing. Your lead car coming out of turn number 4 is the number 10 of Wayne Jostler. Then comes Roger Shepard, the black flag for the 162 of Dave Lesgro. Difficulties and problems with the 162. Off he goes into pit road. Car number 10, Wayne Jostler, your leader. Then comes Roger Shepard in the 3, followed by car number 33, Dick LaPlante Jr. Then comes Bradley Barry Metcalf. Car number 6, the trick 6 of Metcalf. Now starts to put pressure on the 33 of Dick LaPlante. Barry Metcalf now battling to the inside. Wayne Jostler, car number 10, your leader, going into 1 and 2. Now being counted by the number 3, Roger Shepard. Then comes battling Barry Metcalf, car number 6, a man on the move. Then comes Dick LaPlante, car number 33, Paul Thomas in the 26, and Carl Goodell, the 23 of mine. On the outside of Pearl, the 194, Ronnie Bodge. Then comes the 00, Bruce Batchelder. The 8, New Hampshire, Jerry Bly. The 9, New Hampshire, Dennis Albro. Kirby Monteith and Audrey Stevens. And shouting in the rear,
2, the 0-0 of Bruce Batchelder, and the number 9 New Hampshire, Dennis Albro, got together and went up into the Claremont cushion. The 0-0 tried to fire up, is hung up there in the backstretch, and can't get loose. Probably have to get the assistance of a wrecker, and the number 9 New Hampshire, Dennis Albro, now being attended to, also up in the Claremont cushion.
Peter Daniels and the car number 81, Mike Russo.
Green flag for racing. race to hold on the lead. Bob Rock second and car number 70. Between Rob Goodenough and the 1 New Hampshire and the number 76 of Peter Daniels. Let's look at the racing room. Looking for racing room in the 81. Now takes over fifth from Rob Goodenough, who's hung out to dry in the 1 New Hampshire. Brian Kenyon, car number 3. Thinks better of it and backs off. Peter Daniels now starts to challenge Bob Rook for second. Bob Rook goes down low but can't get the job done. Then comes Mike Brousseau in the 81. You battle for second position between three cars as Peter Daniels once again. Advantage to Daniels as they come out of turn number 4 as Brian Kenyon continues standing. Now takes over second. Bob Rook twice to hold off third from the number 81 of Mike Brousseau. Mike Brousseau on the inside. Bob Rook on the outside, car number 70. Then comes the 76 of Peter Daniels. Mike Brousseau in the 81. Bob Rook, car number 70. And the 72 of Bob Levine. Out comes the white flag. One to go. Then the 27 of Jim Boniface. Green flag, we're racing. 22, Lenny Wells, the leader. Now going up to second in the black bandit car. The 32 is Barry Messer. Hung out to dry, Roy Ingraham. As Jim Boniface, car number 27. The one from on of Lenny Runnels, your new leader, Barry Messer, car number 32. Running car number 27 is Jim Boniface. And comes car number 12X of Gary Karen. Car number 27, the one from on, make contact coming out of turn. Battle coming out of turn number 4. Two to go.
121, Punky Karen. Then comes the 74, Lonnie Sawyer. Riding shotgun car number 11 is Brian Baker. Green flag, we're racing. Green flag. We should be ready. Keep your eyes on the race cars, on your starter, green flag, and Ralph Simons picks up speed and holds on.
Yeah.
eyes on 3 and 4. Keep your eyes on the starter. We should have a start this time around. Speeds pick up. Green comes out. We're racing. Car number Z97. A little loading job by the number 8 of Steve Kimmel. Steve Kimmel takes over second after going through the infield. Bonnie Canfield, calling number, out comes the yellow. Out comes the yellow for the number 8 of Ken Fowler. Ken Fowler pulls out the yellow as he loops it coming out of turn number 2. In the pace car, we should be ready to go. Joe Olmsted picks up speed as they come in on turn number 4. Out comes the green and we're racing once again. Bonnie Canfield puts that pedal to the metal as they go into 1 and 2. Joe Olmsted fights the whole ball coming out of number 2. It's Joe Olmsted on the inside. Tommy Canfield on the outside. Joe Olmsted now gets the lead coming out of turn number 4. Joe Olmsted, your leader. Tommy Canfield. Joe Olmsted on the outside is car number 84. Ed Randall loops it out of turn number 2. Then comes the number 5 of Steve Kimmel. Number 4, Mike Burns. Car number 55 is Dwayne Stine. The number 8 is Ken Fowler. Then comes the number 9.
Thank you.
35.
Harlan, Vermont. 305 Chevy Camaro. Sponsored by Olmsted General Contractors, Mosley and Fucci Associates, and M&M Country Store. Owned by Joe Olmsted and his pit crew, your winner, Joe Olmsted, car number 25. On the outside of 30, the number 10 car is Wayne Jostler. Then comes car number 30, Mark Blair. On the outside of Mark, the 27 is Ken Morris. We'll catch the rest of the lineup when we have the opportunity. Speeds pick up. Green flag, we're racing. Green flag, Wayne Jostler.
Second goes Wayne Jostler. And
Smith. Delay a little bit longer. We've got some oil on turn number two. Oil
one. Restarting lap number 21. Andy Johnson, your leader. Car number one. Carol Goodell on the outside. Now comes the green. Green flag. Andy Johnson. Now the Intel's on the inside. Checkered as we get ready to restart this field. Andy Johnson picks up speed. Dave Lescourt on the outside. Green is out. We're racing. Andy Johnson drifts up high. Takes the lead into one and two. Dave Lescourt now being challenged on the inside by Carol Goodell. Carol Goodell and Dave Lescourt momentarily get together. Carol Goodell now takes over as the 162 of Dave Lescourt apparently has a cut tire. One to go. One to go. Taking over the lead. Car number one from White River Junction, Vermont. Sponsored by Coach's Corner, Classic Cut Tans, and Del Roma Restaurant. A 350 Chevy powered Camaro. Your winner, Andy Johnson. Car number one finishes number one. Finishing second, a strong run for this car. Car number 23, Vermont. Out of Lebanon, New Hampshire. Car 355 Chevy Camaro, owned by Keith Vance, sponsored by Bob Pringle, Chevrolet, Volvo, Volkswagen, Geo, Arts Cleaning Service, the 23 Vermont. Congratulations for a strong second finish to Carol Goodell. Finishing third, last week's winner. Car number six out of Charleston, New Hampshire, 355 Chevy powered Camaro, sponsored by A&M Automotive, Big Rose Welding, Schumann Excavating, Eureka Paint and Wallpaper, James Plumbing and Heating, and Bodreau Enterprises was battling Barry Metcalf. Car number six. A nice trophy here for the number one of Andy Johnson. Andy? Andy, you came from 14th position. Your second win this year. You seem to like the outside groove here. Works good for you.
Yeah, it's pretty rough. Got together with a few cars, yeah. Happens every week. Like the outside.
Yeah, you seem to run almost stronger than anyone else on the outside, and then yet you went to the inside when you needed to.
It was handling pretty good tonight.
It sure was. Your sponsor, your pit crew must have helped a lot here to get you here.
Sure did.
Okay, once again, our congratulations to Andy Johnson, second win this year. You need more pictures here for your winner.
Mike Christian. Then comes the 17 of Jerry Brailsford. We'll catch the rest of the lineup for you when time permits. The field's getting ready to start as they come into turn number 3 and 4. Keep your eyes on the starter. Keep your eyes on Keith Loveland and George Fisher.
Green flag and we're racing. 20 lap, green stock, feature race. George Fisher, car number 14. Battling to the outside.
Third, as the car is coming down on the left,
metal, and out comes the yellow flag. 6-7 cars involved. The worst car, the most damage from the 10 of Speedfly. The number 10 Speedfly sitting here with the most damage, a broken radiator, and probably more. The number 10 car taking a severe beating. The 10 driven by Steve Fly, car owned by Steve and Shirley Fly, and sponsored by R. Fly and Sons. A broken radiator plus more damage to the number 10 car of Steve Fly.
Yeah.
Dennis Greenwood moves into number 94, Steve Lamory, also in turn number one. The combination of the two cars bringing out the yellow flag. The number 94 car, Corey Blythe presently running sixth of the number zero. Then comes Tom Pelletier in the 11th and Craig Caron in car number 13. Your top eight cars, the pace car dives in. Turn three, we should be ready to go once again. Green, white, checkered. We've got the green portion. Gary Colbert on the inside. Robin Bly on the outside. Checker, enough is enough, say the officials here at the Speedway. The checker comes out, too much bashing and trashing, and that's the end of the race. Okay, the car that got the checkered flag, the 05 car, was Gary Colbert out of Charleston, New Hampshire, 305. Chevy Camaro, owned by Seth Merrill. Mac Johnston out of Lebanon, New Hampshire, a 302 Ford-powered Granada, sponsored by Gateway Motors, QMI Products, and Quality Tire. Mac Johnston, a trophy in car number 9, also a trophy for the 00 car, and the car getting the checkered was the 05. Of Gary Colbert. Thank you. this year. A classic example of one man's misfortune becoming another man's fortune is race leader Dwight Jarvis, car number 55, unexpectedly pulled out while leading, inheriting the lead, the car number 8, New Hampshire, and then going on for the win. Out of Claremont, a Cavalier body car, Troyer chassis, 364 Chevy engine built by Bill Flynn, the car owned by Roger Canfield, sponsored by Sunset Motors in Alstead. Our blind son's right here in Claremont. His second win this year. Welcome to the winner's circle, Jerry Bly, car number 8 in Hampshire. Finishing second, his best finish this year in the Plum Crazy Car, the 00 out of Springfield, Vermont. Also a Cavalier body Troyer chassis car, 355 Chevy, built by the driver himself. The car owned by Jeff Wright, sponsored by Carney's Market, Pringle Chevrolet, Volvo, Volkswagen, Geo, was Bruce Batchelder, car number 00. A good second for Bruce. Finishing third, his first trophy this year. Car number 33. Out of West Swansea, New Hampshire, Cavalier Troyer car, 368 Chevy engine by Bardwell Engineering. Car owned by Jim Small, sponsored by Sickens Paint, Bumper to Bumper Auto Body, All Pro Auto Parts, and Emily Oil. His first trophy this year. A big congratulations to car number 33, TJ Small. A nice drive for TJ. While I'm getting some pictures here. TJ, come over here for a second. Okay, your first trophy, you got to give a chance here to tell the crowd about your sponsors and also getting your nice third position here.
Hey, well, I got to thank a lot of people. My father, especially, has done a lot of work on the car lately, and I haven't been able to help him, and he really earned this one tonight. Well, I thank my wife for putting up with me all spring while I was working on the car. Of course, my sponsors, Sickens Paints, Emily Oil, All Pro Auto Parts, Rusty Speed, who's been a big, big help, Bardwell Racing, and Terry Wilder, who puts the motors together.
So there it is, and I know your pit crew helps a lot, too, and that includes your dad, right?
Yeah, he's the number one. He's been working hard all spring for this. He just kept telling me to keep it under control and stop that messing around that I've been doing out there.
Well, congratulations. It paid off. A nice third-place trophy for TJ Small. Bruce? Best finish this year, Bruce. It must feel good. Second place.
It sure does. It's only the second time this year we finished.
Well, it's like they say, first to finish, first you have to finish, first you have to finish, right?
That's for sure. We haven't been doing that much, but we hope we get it turned around now.
Well, nice second place. Congratulations to Bruce Batchelder. Nice trophy there. Okay, just before he fires it up here, I guess we don't have enough room. I'll have to come over here. Nice second place, or win for you, your second win this year. What'd you think when Dwight pulled out while he's leading?
I see the motor let go on his car there. I see fluid coming out of the bottom there, so I didn't know if I could keep ahead of the guys that were in back and out. We didn't put new tires on tonight, and then all of a sudden there was that wreck, and kind of made it easy for us tonight.
Nice win, a win's a win regardless. Our congratulations to Jerry Bly.
Thank you. Nice win. On the outside of Bob. Okay, we'll get the rest of them when we can. The speeds pick up, we should be ready to race this time around. Green flag, we're racing.
horse. This Jim Bonifay's legacy, this pleasure, the number 12 X of Gary Karen. Gary Karen doesn't think that he should be mad at the two of them go out of here. Now starts to go to the back of the pack. See how
time. Monkey Karen to jump again. Coming out of 3 and 4.
Side groove, starting from 15th position, his third win this year, the Goshen Ghost, an IROC-Z Rosser chassis car, 355 Chevy engine, by TA Racing, owned by P&S Racing, sponsored by Chase and Avery, Elshute Lumber, Harrington Jewelers, Sunapee Service Center, Carl Hayden Farrier, and Perkinsville Fundraisers, amongst others, his third win this year, the Top Gun 121 Punky Karen. Finishing second in a family feud, it was cousin against cousin. Car number 12X. Also out of Goshen, an IROC-Z car, Rosner chassis, Bardwell Engineering. Car owned by Gary Karen, sponsored by Sabre & Son, Paul & Son, Ford E&S Concrete, and Steve Fellows Chainsaws, was the king, Gary Karen, car number 12X. Finishing third, rim riding on the outside, finally getting through slower traffic to get a trophy for himself in the number 81 car. Lumina Pro Stock chassis car, also by Bardwell Engineering, owned by Brian Burgoyne, Karen Brusso, and Mike Brusso, sponsored by Maxwell House Coffee, Country Time Lemonade, Golden Cross Ambulance, Holson Photo, Hal Johnson Photography, and SAS Auto Parts, was Mike Brusso, car number 81. A nice run for Mike also. Your top three cars, Punky Karen, Gary Karen,
and Mike Crusoe. Then came the 78X of Mike Batchelder, finishing fifth, the 76 car of Peter Daniels. Bucky, a couple of weeks ago, you said once this car gets its handling in, you're going to be tough. Before, a couple of weeks ago, you couldn't hold the inside groove. Tonight, you used the inside groove to your advantage several times. Have you got the handling down where you want it now?
Well, we were in pretty good last week, too, but we didn't have, we had a little bit of bad luck. I broke a throttle spring to begin the race, and that's why I look kind of radical out there. Every time I touched the gas roll, it went full throttle, and I had to pull it up with my, put my toe underneath and pull it up. So that's why we looked kind of bad last week. But that's not nothing to do with the car. The car is going probably better last night than tonight than we've gone all year, and I feel good in the car. The car feels good. The guys have done a heck of a job to get it where it is, and the guys are going to have to be running out if they go by it when it's running like this.
It sure looks like it had the handles and the power tonight for sure.
We had the handles, and a lot of thanks to TNA Engines out of Connecticut. We got some good power. Everybody thinks we're illegal, but we're not. We got the hitch off down at Monadnock. We just got some good power, and thanks to those guys, we're here tonight.
Congratulations, your third win this year.
I'd like to thank all my sponsors too that are on the car. I'm sure that you mentioned them for the evening, so I don't have to go through their names again, but we really appreciate their help very much. Thank you.
Very good. Punky Karen, his third win this year. Okay, don't forget.
Down into the X, out comes the green. Dave Murphy, car number 33, grabs the early lead. He gets spun around. Driving to the inside goes Ronnie Menard. Car number 3, as they get all jammed up there in turn number 2, as they come out of the X, Dave Murphy gets hung up. The blinking blue 2 finally gets going. Car number 7 and the 33 are locked together there as they go out of turn number 2. Ronnie Menard, not even having to work for that lead, finally gets the turn, goes the right way. Oh, here they come, the cars are hooked together, they finally get unhooked as the 33 goes after the 7. Ronnie Menard, meanwhile, your leader, running second, the number 68 is Jim Carley. Now challenging for second on the inside, the 3X car of Crazy Lenny Pillsbury. Car number 7, a flat tire, race one flat tire for Roy Howard, as Ronnie Menard picks his way through turn number 2 and crosses into the X. A distant second comes car number 68, Jim Carley, now being challenged by the 3X car. Jim Carley now clears second, now being challenged by the 3X of Lenny Pillsbury. Ronnie Menard has things his own way as the 68 and the 3X get together. A blowing tire for the 68 of Jim Carley as Crazy Lenny Pillsbury now takes over second. The two team cars, first and second, the 3 and the 3X. A distant third, car number 4 of Sonny West. Almost at the X that time. Neatly at the X. The cars are spread out. Ronnie Menard comes battling through. Going for his 8th win here at the Claremont Speedway. The blinking blue 2 backs out of it as Ronnie Menard goes flying through. In comes Crazy Lenny Pillsbury, the team car. Car number 3X. Running third, car number 4. The 4 driven by Dalton Sunny West. Shoots through the X. Then comes Lenny Pillsbury in the 3X. Mike West. Lenny Pillsbury has things his own way tonight as they all got shuffled up out of turn number two. Pillsbury, Ronnie Menard, dove to the inside, and it was all over. One to go for Ronnie Menard. Car number three, Lenny Pillsbury, crosses through the X. Another half lap to go for Ronnie Menard, your race leader. Lenny Pillsbury splits the blinking blue two and the four. Your leader, now winner, coming out of turn three,